welcome to the warm-up exercises video. Now in this little vid, I'm just going to explain a few warm-up exercises to you, like a little warm-up set of about 10 minutes that you can use to start off your daily practice regime. And that also is really great if you don't have time to practice during some days, but you still have, you know, 10 minutes maybe where you can do something. Then this little starting set is a great way to at least keep your level at the same point. So if you really don't practice for a few days, you'll find that your level very quickly goes down, both on the saxophone and other woodwind instruments and brass instruments like the trumpet. They just need a lot of discipline to keep your tone right and to keep your flexibility. But if you do just this little 10-minute thing, at least this every day, then you'll find that your level at least stays at the same point. And then as soon as you have more time to really go into a real practice of half an hour or an hour or more, then you at least didn't fall down during the time where you had very little or maybe no time to practice. So let's start it off. Now the first thing I always do when I start practicing and to warm up is to really to start with just the mouthpiece. Because of course the horn is really an amplification device for your mouthpiece, but this is really where you create the sound. So make sure your reed is nice and moist. I always put it in some water for a little bit and put it on your mouthpiece. And well, if you have, I happen to have a piano, but if you have a keyboard or another instrument that's very, precise and in tune on your notes, or maybe even a tuning device or a metronome with a tuner on it, works fine as well. Give yourself a note. For example, I usually start on the D, and I actually usually also give myself the octave, so you can really sort of, hear what it sounds like. And then play long notes to start with. And really start to find, to really be precise about your note and have it very crystal clear and straight coming out of your mouthpiece. And of course, also make sure that your posture and everything is great. Now, a few things you can do is, you can play the note really straight, but you can also sort of start really wavy and then try to find it. That's also a great exercise, I find. Because it kind of trains your flexibility. And now of course I'm doing it on the D, but actually when I do it, I really go through the whole thing. So, etc., etc. And of course I wave them, so I do both those exercises. And what you can do after you've really put some attention into that and really make sure your sound on the mouthpiece is crisp and nice and clear and right on the note, then you can actually play some songs on the mouthpiece alone, because you can play really anything you can play on there just on here. So for example, you can play like what I often try to do is the starting line of On Green Dolphin Street. So if you don't know that song, it goes like this. So playing that just on the mouthpiece may sound something like this. And of course, once again, when you're playing that, I'm doing it really fast right now, but really pay attention to the details. Make sure that the notes come out right, that they really sound on the note. And if you have to, if you have your piano or your keyboard near, play the songs, play the melody along, and play along with your mouthpiece and really pay attention to getting your sound clear there. And of course, you're playing your mouthpiece, so it always sounds kind of horrible because it's just so high and it's just not nice to listen to. But you'll find that if you do this every day for 10 minutes or something, just practicing on your mouthpiece, just doing long notes and making sure they sound absolutely crisp, and then, you know, playing some scales or some half scales or some chromatic stuff, you know, along with your piano, and then doing a few songs, you'll find that you do this for a few months and people start talking to you and saying, hey, your tone is really improving, you're getting that nice, you know, warm, open, crisp and clean saxophone sound. And this is really the way to get that, to start off every practice session with some mouthpiece exercises. So once you've done the mouthpiece exercises, of course, put your mouthpiece on your saxophone, and then really do the same on your saxophone. So take maybe 5 minutes more, and first start off with some long notes. So, you know, for example, pick an E. Now, we're warming up here, so you don't want to really do saxophone push-ups where you're really pushing the long note as far as you can and really try and tire yourself out and train your muscles. No, you're more looking for precision here and really creating a beautiful sound. Okay, so the next part of your warm-up set is playing some scales. And the way to do that is to go really, really slowly, and preferably to do it standing up in front of a mirror, and to really pay attention to how you're moving your hands around the saxophone, and to make sure that you're keeping your hands very relaxed and that you're very precise and accurate in the way you're closing the keys, and just, you know, paying attention to all the details and making sure that everything from the very lowest note to the very highest one goes really, really fluently. And this is really the basis for playing fast, because if you want to play really fast things on the saxophone, you know, once you get to songs that are really fast and where you're going to need gambits, like for example, you know, this sort of things, your hands need to be really relaxed. The only way to, if there's any sort of residual structural sort of tension in your hands when you're playing, there will be a level where your speed will just top off. And the more relaxed your hands are and the more precise you are, the more able you'll be to keep being precise at high speeds. And the way to practice this is to really go very slow. And I would start with just the 12 major scales, and to really pick any scale to start. So for example, let's take a D scale, and just to start really slowly. And then, you know, really paying attention to the precision and how you're doing the keys, and having your hands being really relaxed. And then slowly, every time you do it, increase the speed and make sure that you stay absolutely precise. And when you feel that you're sort of getting sloppy, stop and slow down again. So I'll show you. Etc., etc., and make sure that you keep that really spot on, really precise. And of course, do it across the whole range of your instrument, and make sure that everywhere, especially of course in the low register and the high register where you have to switch to using different keys, you can really maintain that speed and retain that precision, because this will seep into your hands and it'll seep into your brain. And just taking, you know, the last 5 minutes, so, you know, do maybe 7 to 10 minutes of just the mouthpiece exercises, and then maybe 5 to 7 minutes of just playing all your scales and making sure that your precision on those is really great, will really help you. First of all, it will help you to warm up and to be precise, and to then go on into an hour of practicing or 2 hours of practicing where you're already very focused and your hands are warmed up, and you've warmed up all the important parts of your body to play really precise and to practice really well. But it will also really create a foundation for a great tone, for, you know, having a voice where people will say, oh wow, that just, you know, each and every note of this guy or girl is just fantastic to listen to. annual lay the foundation for being able to get to those really high speeds that of course are really great to have in your bag, to have as a tool once you start soloing and writing and playing a lot in public. So that's really a few things that you can do to warm up and to start all your practice sessions with, and as a maintenance set. So if you don't have time to practice, but you have at least say 10 minutes a day to do this, then I would say always do this. Make sure that if you don't do anything else, at least do these three exercises. You know, mouthpiece, long notes on the mouthpiece, playing some songs and playing maybe some scales on the mouthpiece, then doing some long notes on the saxophone, and then playing your scales and you know, making sure very precise, and then slowly increasing the speed and increasing the speed and increasing the speed. Okay, so that's it about the warm-up sets. See you again in another video here on Hello Saxophone Live.